And I'm back at it again with the UFC 2. I'm on the Xbox side today. I'm gonna do gameplay with the All-American, the bad boy, Chris Weidman. He is quite possibly my second favorite fighter in the UFC. You know, he's well-rounded. He's a beast. A fucking beast. Look at all that. Look at all that. Oh, these wins I was getting with Weidman yesterday. I didn't even stream. I just was just freelancing playing. I'm like, I'm gonna just run with Chris Weidman and boom, look at that. But yeah, Chris Weidman, he's my second favorite fighter in the UFC. He took a tough loss in 205 against Yoel Romero. I think he'll bounce back. Can't wait for him to come back. So, you know, hopefully he get a fight soon. He bounce back from that. But he did say he's gonna take time to spend time with his family, get some rest or whatever. You know, just try to enjoy himself or whatever. And that Romero fight was brutal. I mean, to fight in his hometown in New York and to, you know, catch the flying knee of death was just crazy. You know, he was doing all right, but then Yoel started wrestling, started grinding him out, and then I think Weidman, he tried to go for a takedown. He went for a shoot, and he just caught the knee of death from Yoel. And props to Yoel for getting that, you know, for winning. But I think Chris Weidman, he's gonna bounce back. He's gonna come back and bounce back, and hopefully, I see him dominate like he was before. You know, he was a good champion. He was the one that knocked Anderson Silva. You know, broke Anderson Silva's record. You know, stopped that streak or whatever. Because Anderson Silva was fucking the king of the middleweight. You know, he had like a bajillion day reign as champion. And so he ran into Weidman, and you know, he was cocky. Weidman caught him, won the title for him, and then they had a rematch where Weidman, not gonna say intentionally broke his leg, but Anderson Silva went for a leg kick, and he threw that shit with ill intent, like he wanted to fucking crack Weidman's leg. But Weidman checked it. Weidman blocked it. He checked it with his knee, and Silva's leg just completely snapped. Like that shit was gruesome. That was so gruesome. Ugh. Ugh. Just thinking about it just gives me makes my stomach hurt. But yeah. Chris Weidman, once he took the title from Silva, you know, he was a champion for a little bit. Then he lost the title to Luke Rockhold, in a good fight. But he made one key error. He tried a wheel kick. Luke Rockhold kind of dipped it, took Weidman down, and pounded him out. Let's look at Chris Weidman. Chris Weidman, 92 in the middleweight division. 96 stand up, 88 clinch, 88 ground. Yes, razor elbows, workhorse, dirty boxer, force of nature, chess master. Let's run with the All-American Chris Weidman. Or the bad boy. Hopefully we have a nice little streak like we did yesterday. Hopefully. Oh, my opponent's taking forever to pick his player. It's probably gonna be a mirror match, especially in the middleweight division. I was hoping to get light heavyweight because a lot of people don't pick him at the light heavyweight division. He's actually the third best fighter in that division, and he's like a taller version of DC, but he can strike too, and he has the reach to keep up with either Jon Jones or Alexander Gustafsson. Sorry guys, I'm not in like my right state of mind right now. I am dead tired. I don't even know why I'm even on the game streaming, because I did the graveyard shit last night. Been up ever since I got home. Oh, he tried to catch him with an early H-bomb, man. I'll try to touch gloves with you, bro.
Anderson first burst onto the UFC scene, Joe, way back at UFC 17 when he captured the UFC middleweight title, which was at 200 pounds back then. But he is most noted for being the first and only fighter in Pride to have held two belts in two divisions simultaneously. And he literally brought those belts into the octagon.
Absolutely. And the knockout victory over Wanderlei Silva is one of the most spectacular knockout highlights in the entire history of the
Pride. I don't want to get into no slugfest with and
big left hand.
See, of course, that could happen.
And this crowd is very loud and very Ooh. Supportive of the All-American Chris Weidman.
Just keep him at bay with those kicks. You can clinch up a little bit. I don't mind clinching with Henderson. Henderson is good in clinching. But he's not on Weidman's level, so we're going to mix that up a little bit when we get our chances.
Just over three now. Henderson with a good punch. Nice roundhouse kick to the body. Weidman with a good jab. Back and forth. And a right behind it.
Weidman. He has power in the middleweight division, but
quick slip of the left.
Not enough. See, because everything I throw, you know, Henderson can throw and return fire.
Chris Weidman with some vicious body shots. Mixes it up. Man, Joe, it's going according to game plan here. Defend and counter. Absolutely. Nice hand. Clean, straight punch. Great utilization of the jab.
Taking out that body.
Joe, once again, looking for those counter strikes. Oh, there he connected. Vicious leg kick from Weidman. Nice job slipping the punt. And a good jab. He's able to block the punt. Nice leg kick. He's doing a really good job of timing these shots. Nice punch.
Smooth, keep moving.
And he's looking for that left. Weidman with the 1-2. That's a good straight punch.
Yes, that's what we're looking for.
Here,
so you got strikers, you can do that. You can look for getting hit and just throwing 1-2, 1-2-3s. And you got strikers.
Precise jab by Weidman.
So I don't want to happen. Clinch out real quick.
And he loves that uppercut. He loves the dirty boxing.
Alright.
He gets the move back.
Let's take him down. Get that takedown.
Gets the takedown. Chris Weidman displaying that power. And the round comes to
all right, go round for us. I think we won that round. Check out the stats real quick. Yeah, definitely won that round. We landed 20 out of 36, 56 out of 78 total, and we got that total. Got that takedown. Excuse me.
And here's another kick to the body. Very impressive striking going on in that round.
All right. Look at my dog, he's all knocked out.
Round two. Joe, there were
and his stamina's pretty good, so.
That was a decent first round.
That's the problem when you got Dan Henderson. You gotta watch his stamina. Dude's an old fart. We're letting our hands fly a little bit.
Yeah, he's deceptively good at distance, Mike. That's one of the things about him, the way he moves.
Tagging the body up. Oh, he's hurt.
He's stunned. He's in trouble, though. Hard straight punch.
Big combination.
Letting him fly a little bit.
Solid jab.
Try to take us down.
Powerful kick to the
midsection. Oh, he's down. We're going to let him get up. We're going to let him get up. We're gonna play an all around MMA game.
Brutal elbows here. Nice elbow to the body by Weidman. He lands another elbow.
This is what he's doing.
Passes to the half guard. Big body punch.
Nope. I don't think he's going wrong.
Henderson's damage on his body is very visible, and it continues to get worse.
Nice punch to the body. Transitions back to full guard.
About to have. Oh, shit. See, I'm so tired. Like, I thought the thing was up. the circle filled up. So tired. I'm not even paying attention. Like,
good work keeping busy on the ground. Nice knee to the body.
Weidman with that. I can keep it. I can actually keep it here if I want to.
Wow, brutal knee.
I might just soften him up real quick. Yeah, soften him up. Maybe with a little transition fake, but that's alright. That's not a problem. He's probably gonna try to get up. Yep. See if we get that. Boom.
That is just amazing technique.
Oop, went the wrong way.
Completely lost the position. Now he's in half guard.
For the backside. Oh no, he blocked it. He blocked it. Go to backside.
Ah, nice sweep, very good move. Strong elbow to the head by Weidman.
But it's oh, half nope. Guard. Got the half guard. Nope.
Weidman with the good knee to the body.
Lands a nice knee, and again.
Nope, no fakes for you. Nope. Nope. To the top.
Ahead to round three.
Round's over. But we won that round, got the knockdown. It's a pretty good round for us. I think it's time to turn up the third round. Maybe we should turn up, or maybe we should continue to play our game. Let's see what he wants to do. He has to come to us. He knows he's losing the fight, so. Yeah, see? He's looking for that H-bomb. Nope. I know you want that H-bomb.
Good straight to the body by Weidman. Chris Weidman's continuing to attack that.
He certainly is targeting it, and the more that eye swells, the less his opponent's going to be able to see the punches coming. Doing an excellent job of mixing up his strikes here.
Sorry, I ain't afraid to bang with you now. Ain't got no stamina.
That's a solid strike.
You looking for the H-bomb, baby.
Good job.
The H-bomb ain't gonna work for you.
Weidman counters with the right. Joey talked about it earlier, and here he continues to
keep
his opponent.
Chill out, no stamina. Nope.
By utilizing that jab. Solid shot with the left by Henderson. He's doing a really good job of timing his shots and landing a good series of strikes here. Weidman gets caught by a straight right.
Yeah, you about to go down.
Yeah, again, nice straight right. And there's the body kick. Very nice shots landing.
Ah, that's a big straight to the body.
Oh! He's doing a great job blocking these shots.
Henderson gets hit with that.
Yeah, so now you're trying to parry.
Good block, and he delivers the straight counter.
Looking to soften up his opponent.
Oh, man. He's hurt to the body. You can tell that shot hurt him bad. Oh, he's going for it here. Oh, nice kick to the liver.
And he's buckled.
Good fight.
Oh, my.
Good fight, bro.
Just like that.
Got him out of there.
It was that nasty body kick that stopped this fight.
Chris Weidman, baby. Let's get it. It was a mismatch, you know. He had Dan Anderson. It was a total mismatch, though. I want to go get somebody that, you know, uses like Rockhold or somebody. If I'm in middleweight, get Rockhold. If I'm in light heavy, get John Jones. Feel me? Shout out to the two viewers that's in this stream. Appreciate the love and support. Put down the comment section, you know, state your name, say what's up, good morning, all that, you know what I'm saying? We in here, we trying to get some wins with the All-American bad boy, Chris Weidman, former middleweight champion of the world, and we in middleweight again. Let's rock out with the, let's rock out with him. I said, playing on the Xbox side gets me... You know, playing on UFC on the Xbox side gets me prepped up for when I go against the top dogs on the PS4 side, because PS4 side, UFC 2 is more competition than on the Xbox. Xbox has competition, but the PS4 is a different monster, man. People on the PS4 that play play UFC, man, it's like they life depend on it, man. So you got to come in there with your A game, for real. People all over the world, India, China, Japan, be on PS4. So, wrecking shit. All right, touch gloves with you. Respect. It's a mirror match. He's blue gloves, Weidman. I'm red gloves, Weidman. Let's play this game. Pretty safe. Leg kick. He's leading with the body kick. Help me with the hook. Try to throw the little four-piece combo. We sway that. Tip for everybody that's watching this broadcast: if your opponent throws combos on the, you know, regular, they throw like four hit combos, and they land one, key move is just not to get hit by all them shits. You know, don't get hit. If you get hit by one or two shots and you're throwing just two shots, then you're winning the battle. And you're winning the battle. Because you're going to blow out his stamina faster than you are. You just got to make sure your shots land clean. Make sure your shots count. So he's using my head movement. He hit me with two of those. But he couldn't get what he wanted at the end. Well, alright, we're going to the body now. I missed my kick. Try to head kick. I could have went for a takedown there, but I'm gonna keep it standing. I'm just try to fill him out real quick on the feet. Oh, the straight jab. Oh, good head kick. Bounce back with a leg kick. Oh, try to head kick again. Oh, missed the hook. That's like my favorite strike in the game. That hook to the body, roundhouse hook to the body. Man. Picking these people off of that straight down body hook, you know, straight down roundhouse hook to the body. That's my favorite combo in the game. Solid punch by Weidman. He got me down. I welcome this. He gets the mounted crucifix. He got me on crucifix.
That's a big elbow, Joe.
Huge elbow.
All right, let's go to side saddle. Call me with a few elbows. Nope. Nah. Let's get up. Got that tape now. I promise. We're going to get ours back. Oh, maybe not. Call with the elbow.
Oh, that's a big left. Wow, swinging a miss. Big uppercut.
Oh, chill out before I get knocked out. Good shot. Call me with the elbow. Death. Good shot. Hey, probably got that round. He got the takedown. Got the rock. He got that round. Even though we landed at a better percentage, landed a little bit more, six, only two more, but and landed more total strikes. I still give him the round off of the strength of the takedown and the, you know, the rock at the end. So I give him that. We still got another two rounds to do.
Now starting off, touch his left. Gotta think that the barrage that he endured in that last round is still affecting him. He's gonna want to start this round off and move and avoid.
So we tagging him up. He's not really doing that much on the feet.
Joe, you're right. Those leg kicks are really starting to slow down his opponent.
Come on, let me talk to you.
Good uppercut.
Nope.
Going for the takedown here.
Let's go down. Take him down. So we're gonna get that takedown back. Nah. Stop trying to be a Spider-Man.
Punishing knee to the body from side control.
Let's the amount of damage that has been done to his body. Do some body work.
He's got a broken rib or two.
Waiting, but we blocked that again. Oop. You gonna stay here for a little bit. You wanna stay here for a little bit. You wanna stay here for a little bit. Just a little bit. No, we're gonna touch up on you a little bit. Nah, nah, don't start spamming. Don't start spamming. Because when you start spamming, I could go for the submission. 3 minutes. I could go for the submission if you want me to. I could tap you out. I don't wanna tap you out. Oh, no, you don't want to do that. Let's go high and down.
Weidman with a good knee to the body. And he connects. Good knees.
All right, let's see what you want to do. What you want to do?
Big body punch.
Oh, he's got up. Look at that stamina. That stamina is low.
Right on that cut. Oh, double jab. Back and forth. He misses with the straight right. Nice job keeping those hands busy. Wow.
Body kick.
Clean jab. Whiteman's left eye is starting to swell up. Oh, nice body shot. Oh. He's really mixing things up tonight. And he lands the roundhouse.
Ah, I keep running to them.
Oh,
all right.
Oh, what an exchange. Wow, he is throwing some huge kicks here. Hard straight punch.
All right. No, yeah, he got it. Nope. That's good round. Now he can only afford to throw a few strikes at a time. You know, we got way more stamina than him. The position is good. Then we're gonna turn it up this round. We probably gonna finish him. Then we're gonna finish him. I know you can probably hear me. I'm not trying to gloat, but I'm gonna get the finish.
He's one of the most heavy-handed fighters in the UFC today. Man, Joe, he is truly showing his striking skill. Weidman with some good kicks. Tagged him.
Locked all that.
Nice, oh, nice kick. There's a body shot. There's a solid body shot. Good job of timing strikes here. Let's take a look at the striking accuracy for Chris Weidman, landing 67% of his strikes. Oh, man, that leg kick did some damage. Oh, very nice.
He's moving pretty good.
Oh, big right. Oh, combination. Powerful jab. Big shot.
Oh, I went for the Superman punch and it did that.
Solid shot to the body.
Yeah, he's looking for that one shot. Move back. Chill out.
Oh, and another jab.
Yeah, come on. Come on.
That's a solid hook. Oh, he's going for it here.
There you go. Use that movement because you know you're going to get tagged.
Big right hand. He's looking for that elbow. Weidman's really showing some bruising on the left side of his body. Great utilization of the jab.
Ah, little lat.
Jab. Nice strikes landing.
I cannot get him.
Weidman with a good left. Vicious shots to the body. Good jab by Weidman. Another left to the body. Hard body kick from Weidman. Oh, nice. Doing an excellent job of mixing up his strikes here. Weidman with a good right. A kick to the body.
Man, that didn't rock him.
Big power jab. Oh, what an exchange. Oh, he nailed
him. Yeah, I got it too, bro.
He is in big trouble, Mike. Huge kicks.
Oh, yeah.
Hard straight punch. Beautiful body shot there, too.
I think he let his elbow hit me.
Liver,
ah, how did that not?
big straight punch.
Game over. Good fight, bro. Good fight, bro.
Beautiful timing and execution for a knockout blow.
Got him out of here. Knockout. Doesn't get the finish, man. Doesn't get the finish. Boom.
This fight. Let's see it one more time. Look at the power in this hook as it lands for the knockout.
Here is Bruce Buffer with the.
That was a good fight. Good fight. Give him props. He was surviving. Pipita 97. Check out these records real quick. Division 4, 187. Played all right, though. I'll give it to him. Played all right. Let's keep it going. Keep it going. Keep it going. Got some nice featured fighters here. I got Rory McDonald, Korean Zombie, Chan Sung Jung, and Kyoji Haraguchi in flyweight. And, I mean, I would say he's a okay pick, but Gabriel Gonzaga, God, Jesus. I used him one time when I had him as my future fighter. I won the fight, surprisingly. Dude had Cain Velasquez. I won the fight, surprisingly. And it was bad. It was bad. He is slow as all fucks. Slow as all hell, man. Gabriel Gonzaga feels like a slug stuck in the mud. He won't move.
Coming up next, it's a light
heavyweight. Yep, Johnny Bones Jones,
the All-American Weidman and the youngest champion in UFC history. Johnny Bones Jones. Our tale of the tale.
What I welcome right here, I welcome this. Fight.
Jones is 28, Weidman is 31. Jones is 2 inches taller. He will have a 6-inch reach advantage. Chris Weidman, John Jones.
This is what I welcome. John Jones. That's what I want. What do you want to do? I'll throw them kicks. Keep me at bay. I understand, bro.
Takedown ability are a huge factor in his success. Keep an eye out for those tonight.
Where? The fight goes to the clinch. Oh no.
Nice kick by Weidman. Misses the takedown. Good jab. Oh, beautiful kick to the body.
Where?
He is going after it here.
Oh, did he snap that kick?
Come here.
Big takedown.
Keep the pressure. Yep, you don't know what you're doing. You don't know what you're doing. Oh, I went the wrong fucking way. I went the wrong way. Come here. Come here. Come here. I'm going to talk to you for a minute. We're going to talk.
You can hear that one.
We're going to talk because you don't know what you're doing.
Man landing in that exchange. Good counter.
Weidman with the combination. Just over three now. We're going to take him down again. Nice combination, and it sets up the takedown.
Nope. Oh, you're going to be mad at me. You're going to be mad at me.
Inside control, tying up that arm, looking for the Kimura. He's got his arm pinned down. He yanked out of the Kimura.
That's good for that guy. I want to go for that guy.
He's looking for a Kimura. Now into the armbar. He let go of the Kimura and he's going for the armbar. That was a deep armbar, but a beautiful escape. Full guard here. Beautiful reversal.
Not today, ball.
That's a big shot right there.
Nice job by White. Transitions to side control.
It's definitely all around. Yeah, I don't know.
He's looking for the Kimura. He transitions to the arm bar. Break the grip.
Got it. Good game. Got it.
The round was almost over, but he sunk in the submission and got the victory.
Joe, here's the finish. That's what he does, man. Chris Weidman, man. I'll take him against John Jones, man. It's like I said, Chris Weidman in the light heavyweight division is basically a taller version of DC. It's basically what he is, taller version of DC. Let's go back to light heavyweight. I don't want to do middleweight again because I know they're going to probably put me in middleweight. Taller version of DC. That's what he is. Seems like my opponent is taking a while to pick his player. It's not hard. Go ahead against John Jones. You know you want to. You know you want to. Let's get it popping. Hope y'all can hear me. Ooh, we going against Gusto? That's all I needed to know. My audio is being broadcasted. Chris Weidman, my viewers can hear me. Let's get it. And I'm going against my favorite UFC fighter, Gusto. Oh.
Alexander Gustafsson has excellent elbow strike technique, and I think that could play a huge part of this fight.
Ah, a little laggy. It's a little laggy.
Smooth, Joe. Very nice transition to side control. He's got full. Oh, no, half guard.
So back to side control.
Moving and transitioning here on the ground.
Good knee to the body from side control.
And he quit. And he quit. Once I saw the 1-2 head kick, I knew that. That's basically what he wanted to do. So, to neutralize that, to stifle that, you do what I did. Take him to the ground. And then you force the rage quit. 14% did not finish. 49-968. A's in Division 6. Should be in Division 2. Let's get another one. That was funny. That was funny. That was funny. Excuse me. Chris Weidman. again, my opponent is taking forever to pick his person.
Coming up next, it is our main event of the evening between Chris, the All-American Weidman, and the youngest champion in UFC history, Johnny Bones.
Johnny Bones Jones.
Oh, tale of the tape.
Right, let me stop. I'm about to play some music, but I'm afraid that I'm gonna get copyright, so I'm not gonna do it. Risk reactions. So have a good fight. Oh no. No taunting. Oh no, no parry. Oh no, buddy. Don't taunt. It's not gonna turn out good for you.
Vicious leg kick from Weidman.
Combination by the champion.
Chill out.
The flying knee.
Chill out.
He lands a head kick.
Ouch.
Big shots.
No, chill out. Chill out with those kicks. I'm telling you. You better chill out.
Try some serious power in that kick, but misses.
Come here, let me talk to you for a minute. Oh no, he went to backside.
And he gets reversed.
Stop. Stop. Nope. I got the All-American. This is a collegiate wrestler. All-American collegiate wrestler, man. This is what he's known for. He's known for his wrestling. No, we're not gonna do that again. No, we're not gonna do that either. No, we're not gonna do that either. Stop spamming. What? That what? Wait. How did he kill?
That is a big hammer fist.
No, we're not getting up. No, you're not getting up. No, stop. Right, let me get you in this kimura real quick. Let me make love to your arm real quick. Oh my God.
Beautiful escape.
Full guard now.
Oh, why? My J. You have no stamina. You're going to keep spamming transitions. Yeah, you don't know what you're doing. I could just end you right now. I'm going to play around with you on the ground. No. Let me get you in that Kimura again, man. Let me try to see that.
Inside control here. He's looking for the Kimura. Trying to lock it up. He's got his arm pinned down.
Great technique being utilized. Trying to finish this fight.
That's going to have to tap. Locked in, Mike.
Oh, it's over. Good game. Broke his arm. I broke his arm. Ain't one tap, I broke his arm.
And once he got it, the fight was over.
Time now for our fight replay.
Let's take a look at the setup here. And here it is again. Absolutely perfectly executed. And here we see it again. Beautiful submission victory.
With the official decision.
That was too easy. Broke his arm. Oh Lord, they really. So this is what I'm talking about. Ain't no competition on this side of the board. PS4, my J, they would have been throwing me in there with Division 8 people left and right. It's a light heavyweight. Whoa, what the hell? That just scared the hell out of me. I think we got somebody got a mic. Oh, we're going to get Rumbo.
Everything between these two fighters tonight is virtually identical. And with the official introductions, here's the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Oh, somebody watches some Ricky J Sports on the vlog. God damn. Somebody getting some of that ground tutorial for Ricky J Sports.
White trunks for Johnson. Black trunks for Weidman. Anthony Rumble Johnson is an excellent fighter, and one particular technique to look out for in this fight is his utilization of the elbow strike.
Very comfortable mixing things up.
These guys are going at it here right away, trading blows.
Continuing to strike well.
Solid jab.
And again, he's looking to unload. Weidman connects. Joe, he's one of the most.
Man, let me talk to you. Let me talk to you for a minute. Let me talk to you for a minute, bro.
That one blocked. Looking for the single. Oh.
Alright, he knows what he's doing. Going for fakes. Okay. Sorry, I welcome this. I welcome it, bruh. I gotta play a little smart. We got a little.
Works the double underhooks here.
Ah. Oop.
Goes for a single.
Ah, you know what? I should have went through the fucking muscle, man. Okay. Alright.
Good ground and pound to the body by John.
I say he getting them tips off of Ricky J Sports.
Nice work.
He's got an over and an under here.
Solid right by Weidman.
They battle in the clinch, looking for a dominant position.
Let me get that though.
Weidman gets the takedown.
Under two. So you can get up. He's a faker though.
And they're back up.
Good takedown defense. Very nicely done.
He's in a great position now with double underhooks. He scores with the knee.
He scores with the knee.
Johnson's got double underhooks.
And he pummels out of it.
And he pummels out of it.
Good takedown by Rumble. We always talked about his striking, Joe. But he won 104 straight wrestling matches in high school.
Elbow. He's taking some hard shots on the bottom, Mike.
Half guard. That cut on his face is really deep, and the blood is really starting to pour out. Great punch by Weidman.
He's in half guard.
Oh, smooth, Joe.
Very nice transition to side control.
Good ground and pound by Johnson. Final seconds of this round.
I dig it. I dig it. Finally a competitive match.
Here's a nasty ground and pound elbow. There was some really good ground and pound in that round.
There's the beautiful Brittany as we get set for round two. Round two. Comes out swinging. Johnson with a kick to the body.
Tagged him.
Oh, parrying. Now he's parrying.
There he goes with a 1-2.
Come on, back up. Back up with that.
Good job blocking the punch. Nice hand. Weidman's cruise on his body.
Back up.
Continues to get worse. It looks ugly. Nice straight to the body.
Both men landing in that exchange.
As we
break down this fight, we look into the number of leg kicks.
Come on.
Precise jab by Rumble.
Good job of timing this.
Oh my God, you're in a slugfest.
Found a home for that. He was able to block that big punch to the head. Man, is he defending nicely.
To the body.
Come on, stop trying to parry.
Nicely done. He slipped the punch.
Straight right.
Come on.
Big swing and a miss by Johnson.
Come on.
Nice work on the counter.
Come on.
Oh, that's a great block of that big kick.
No, no 1-2 head kick for you. Come on.
Big kick misses.
Big kick misses.
Oh! What an exchange! Nice takedown. Now to full guard. Oh, beautiful sweep. Nice elbows by White.
Nah. Not at all. I gotta read your pattern on your fakes. That's all you're doing is faking me. Nope.
Weidman gets it back into his guard.
Go ahead, go for your fake. Fake. I know.
He's staying busy on his back. Nice elbow.
Now he's stacking him. Look at that eye, man. That is a mess.
Ah, I went that way. Come on.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Always trying to better his position.
90 seconds now on the clock.
Nice punch to the body. And now he's going to try to stand up, and he does.
That's a nice punch by Weidman.
Wow! This could be it.
Oh, this shit. So that's what I get for trying to go for a slugfest. No.
Big connection with the elbow. Solid right hand.
No. Really?
30 seconds.
Wait.
Good roundhouse kick to the midsection.
And a right behind it.
Oh.
Big hook blocked by Weidman.
Mm-mm.
Oh, nice.
Oh, good connection by both men.
Let me get that. Can't finish.
Down by Weidman. And that's the end of round number two.
Can't finish me, though.
That's a nasty.
It's going to cost you.
Nasty. Chris Weidman's nose is a mess.
That's about as bad.
The beautiful gen.
It sound good, bro. It sound good. You're better than me at all the master bets. Why can't you finish me?
Third and final round.
He's definitely going to want to start this round off fast to try to pick up where he left off. His opponent was in big trouble at the end of that round.
Another good strike. He scores with the leg kick. Weidman with the combination.
Come on.
Look at that. He's timing that jab. And he lands the roundhouse. That bruise on his outer thigh is getting much worse.
Combination. Left, right. Let's take a look at the striking accuracy for Chris Weidman. Landing 72% of his total strikes. Joe, his...
Wow! This could be it right here.
Nice combination.
He is going after it here. Big straight punch.
There's a nice combination.
Oh, big right hand clipped him. Powerful right hand. Oh, he's going for it here. Powerful left hand.
Great job blocking that punch. Good jab. Nice roundhouse kick to the body. Good connection with the straight by Weidman. Joey lands again. Right on that cut. Weidman gets the single.
He's got full guard.
Nice work to the body by Weidman.
Why? Because you faked me like 80 million times?
And he's able to get back up to his feet. Oh, he got clipped. Oh, he lands the roundhouse to the body.
I give it to you. You got a nice little
Joe
fake transition.
Nice that punch.
Good. Come on.
Combinations landing.
Come on. Come on.
Rumble with a kick to the body.
Come on.
Nice jab.
Anthony Johnson is continuing to attack that bad eye.
He certainly is targeting it, and the more that eye swells,
come on, come on. He's
going to be able to see the punches coming.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Excellent job.
Come on, bro. Yeah, come on. Come on to Paris. Straight by Johnson. Shit gets real, don't it?
1-2 connects.
No, no. This has been an absolutely
crazy fight, and the pace is still kept up in this last minute. These guys are going for it and trying to finish. Vicious combinations. Hard jab.
Oh, big body kick. Hurt him with that right. Wow, how good is this? Hard straight punch. Combination. Oh, and another one. That hurt him.
Nice jab. Nasty combinations here.
Mm-mm.
There's a left that connects. He tagged him.
Big shots. Come on. Come on. There you go. Good fight, bud. Good fight, baby. Good fight, baby. You got me. That was a good fight, though. 4 out of 5 takedowns. I landed more 6. I guess they give it to him because he was more of an aggressor. But that's all right. That was a good fight. Finally got a nice little competitive match. Division 7? Yeah, finally. Finally got a good match. Let's keep it going. Keep it going, fellas. Keep it going. That was a non-title fight too. God damn. Took an L. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Luke Rockhold.
Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. Both of the fighters are 31. Rockhold is 1 inch taller. Weidman will have a 1 inch reach advantage. Once again, here's the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, Luke Rockhold. That's what I've been looking for. I didn't know it was on me. I've been pressed there. Sorry.
Here we go.
Both champions. I watch out for Rocco. Rocco is the John Jones of his division. The funny kick.
We've seen many title fights over the year, but you have been as much anticipated as this match.
Many kicks, man.
One of the best fighters ever to compete in the Octagon. Only one man will leave with the belt.
The time is here. We've been waiting for this for a long time. The fans are hyped up, and this is one of the most highly anticipated world championship fights ever. An absolutely enormous fight right now. Getting in position for an armbar.
Almost had the armbar.
Oh, yeah, this is another guy. I don't know what he's doing. 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 Let me end this real quick.
Nicely done. It's pretty deep, Mike.
Ah, fuck! I messed up.
Half guard.
Ah.
to stay busy, though, Joe. Somebody's got to go for something here.
He's working from full back mount.
Flattened him out.
He's working from his back again. He postures into place.
Weidman connects. Ray Longo loves that one.
Half guard.
Joe, he's keeping busy. Nice knee to the body. Could he pull it off right here?
Oh, this is bad to watch.
What? That's it. I said I didn't even register first off. What the hell? Sorry.
He got the fight for the tap.
Alright.
Joe, here's the finish on our fight replay.
Let's see it again here. Got the choke.
And here he is with the.
That guy just wasn't good at all. Dogs play fighting with each other right now. Get on my damn nerves. You know, y'all probably can hear them growling and mumbling and all that shit.
Coming up next, it's a middleweight matchup.
Robert Lawler.
The All-American Weidman and knockout artist, Robbie Lawler.
Yeah, need to chill out.
Weidman is 3 inches taller. He will have a 4-inch reach advantage.
And a 4-inch reach advantage.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting at the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of.
Oops, on me.
Chris Weidman, Robbie Lawler.
Oh, man.
Here we go. Our fight today,
Robert Lawler,
three,
offset
round.
Corner. All right.
White trunks for Lawler, black trunks for Weidman. Such a long
journey. We gotta watch out for Robbie Lawler. Lawler, so he even got heavy hands in this division. So, can get into no fist fight with him.
He has a great wrestling base as well.
But his takedown defense has really improved dramatically since he went to American Top Team. Just the full array of coaching available to him there. He's really changed his game.
Ah, see. Oh, get paid for it.
He went 6 years without sparring, which is pretty incredible.
Lawler with a big right kick to the body. Wow, what a great job mixing things up.
Good defense there.
Good defense there.
Chris Weidman with some vicious body shots. Vicious.
Absolutely, Joe. Punishing shots to the body. Man, this crowd is very loud and very supportive of the All-American Chris Weidman.
Nice shot.
Heavy kick to the midsection.
What a jab.
What a jab.
So that's one thing we can't do, get reckless.
That's a hard inside leg kick. The jab connects.
He's looking for that elbow.
He's one of the most heavy-handed fighters in the UFC today. Slips and rips.
He's doing a great job of timing these shots.
He blocks the punch.
He blocks the punch.
Oh, he tagged him with that hook to the head.
With that hook to the head.
Nice.
Nice 1-2.
Oh, he lands the roundhouse to the body. He continues to score with his strike.
Good punch. And he lands the roundhouse.
Jab, jab. Big kick just missed.
Big kick just missed.
Oh, there he connected.
Oh, there he connected.
Good roundhouse kick to the midsection. And he connects here.
And he connects here.
Strong inside leg kick by Robbie.
Leg kick by Robbie.
And he lands again.
And he lands again.
Tagged him. Look at this.
Good jabs by Lawler.
Good jabs by Lawler.
Nice roundhouse kick to the body.
Oh, on the elbow, finally.
Last 15 seconds of the round.
There's a body shot. There's a solid body shot. He's really doing a good job of controlling distance and getting off these shots.
The horn sounds for the end of round number one.
Good first round. I just got a notification that one of my friends are.
And here's a nice kick to the body that lands. And here's another kick to the body. And here's one more perfectly placed kick to the body. Incredible striking on display in that round.
The lovely Jenny. Continues round two. Joe, we saw a bit of action in the first round.
They're getting each other's timing down, starting to figure out the distance, and I think they're going to get after it now. Good check.
Good check.
Big roundhouse kick.
Big roundhouse kick.
It's a nice jab there, Joe.
Nice
the most significant
there, Joe.
Stat in this fight has been body strikes. Nice kick to the body.
Big straight punch.
Big straight punch.
Vicious combination.
Vicious combination.
Beautiful body shot
beautiful
there.
Nice combination.
Nice combination.
Oh!
Oh!
He connects again.
He connects
oh, that's
again.
A heavy body kick.
Oh,
hard straight punch.
Good
hard
combination.
He is going,
he
after,
is
it
going
here.
After it here.
Solid jab.
Solid jab.
Under three.
Under three.
Oh, oh
huge
landed
uppercut.
Landed
huge
uppercut.
Big combination.
Big combination.
Hard straight punch.
Hard straight punch.
Huge uppercut misses.
Huge uppercut misses.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, did he snap that
oh,
kick?
I like that, Mike. I like how he's mixing it up.
Weidman connects. Ray Longo loves that.
Hard left hand.
Hard left hand.
Nasty combinations
nasty
here.
Combinations here.
Oh, big body
oh,
kick.
Big body kick.
That's
huge
a solid
shot
hook.
Huge
big
shot.
Big shot.
Big shot.
Oh, solid jab.
Oh, solid jab.
Body kick, look at that.
Oh, he's landing.
Oh, he's landing.
Big straight punch.
Big straight punch.
Another ferocious
another
body
ferocious
kick from
Weidman.
Joe, you're absolutely right.
Joe, you're
kicks
right.
For the body.
How?
Oh, man.
He got nailed in the body. He
nailed
is
in
big
body.
Trouble
he
here.
Big trouble here.
Oh, that one hurt him.
Oh, that one hurt him.
Final minute of round two.
Hard straight punch.
Hard straight punch.
He connects with the left.
He connects with the left.
Oh my God.
He's doing a really good job of timing his shots.
Nice straight to the body
nice
by Lawler.
To the body by Lawler.
He's doing a great job blocking
he's
these shots.
Blocking these shots.
I don't believe I didn't blow up his block yet. Man, crazy. Ah, man, we almost ended it there. Got him out of there.
Here in the replay, it's this nasty body shot. He's in big trouble here. He buckles over. And this
my liver.
Bruce Buffer has the...
A fight to offset Corn. Damn good fight. Play well with Robert Lawler. Let's get like two more fights in. They're not gonna end it. Tired. We in the light heavyweights divisions. Trey, what's up with you, bro? How you feeling today? You alright?
Showcase between Chris, the All-American Weidman.
Let me go get Jimmy Manoa.
Our tale of the tape for this life.
You're gonna get James Manoa.
Manoa is 5 years his elder. The rest is virtually identical. And once again, here's Bruce Buffer.
Oh, I forgot Chris Weidman was fighting Gegard Mousasi in Buffalo. Hopefully he can pull that one out. That's a UFC 210. Gotta order that. Gotta watch my boy Chris Weidman rebound, man. But Mousasi ain't no, he ain't no sweet chicken, man. Sweet and sour chicken. Oh, my fault. My fault. I ain't know you want to touch gloves. I don't know.
Big swing and a miss by Manoa. He slips and rips. Manoa with the double jab. Now we have ourselves a fist fight.
Oh, my nose itch.
Oh, my nice goodness.
Kick to the body. Nice,
man.
Done.
You could hear that one.
He's doing a great job of being unpredictable.
I'm tired.
Mixing things up here.
Ooh.
Manoa gets caught by a straight right.
Yeah, my turn. My turn.
Yeah, again, nice straight right.
Good striking. Hit him with the jab. Great utilization of the jab.
Oh, double jab. Good job landing that series of punches here.
Manoa with a nice punch.
Ah.
A
That's a great block of the punch.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange.
Wow, that's a big left hand.
Ah, you motherfucker.
Big head kick, and this may end the fight. That a huge right hand.
Can't believe I got caught by that. What? Wow. Okay.
He's got side control.
Not gonna do that.
Oh, some heavy shots from the top.
You better get up. Okay.
He continues to score with his strikes.
He gets that double underhooks. Pummels out of double underhooks here.
Under two.
That was a nice jab. He's taking some shots now.
Nice kick to the body.
No. Not getting a head kick again.
Turning into an all-out slugfest.
Oh, over the top. Oh, beautiful combination.
Parrying. I like that. I like to see that.
Hard left hand.
So you ain't got head movement like me.
Big left punch.
Why did I do that? I could do it too. I could do the 1-2 head kick.
Powerful left hand.
Combination.
I just choose not to do that shit. Because it's so fucking cheesy. It's so easy.
Another one. That hurt him.
Oh, big punches here.
Nice roundhouse kick to the body.
We got tagged there.
Weidman's face is a mess.
Damn, can I fucking sway? Good shit. Good shit. Great rock love. Got that knockdown. Landed at a better percentage. He landed more. Alright, when I get hit like that.
Second round. Comes out swinging. Softening his opponent up. Trying to set something up here. Oh, he lands the roundhouse to the body. Wow!
Are you kidding me, man?
Done.
Rocked him with that right hand. Big hammer fist.
Huge bomb from the top.
Big elbow.
Oh, come on, man. This shit. That's bull. That is 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 bull. They would not let me transition out of that shit. Division 8? He was Division 8? He didn't feel like it. He didn't feel like it at all. Oh, man. He didn't feel like a Division 8 person at all. He actually a bum. But he called me with the magic combo. Can't get mad at it. I'll be with Jimmy against Jimmy Manuel. At all people. I should have just took him to the ground. Like, initiate the grappling. I just feel this fucking striking wasn't better than mine. He just got a lucky head kick. Two lucky head kick knockdowns. Two lucky head kick knockdowns. It was a non. Wow, I'm losing these non-title fights, man. I'm going in as the champion, losing these non-title fights.
Heavyweight matchup between Chris, the All-American Weidman, and the longtime middleweight champion, Anderson, the Spider Silva. Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight fight
The American is 31. The Brazilian is 40. Weidman will have a 1-inch reach advantage. Once again, here's the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 33 wins, 8 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Curitiba, Brazil, presenting the former UFC middleweight champion of the world, Anderson!
Chris Weidman, Anderson Silva. And here we go. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Anderson Silva. Black trunks for Weidman.
Anderson Silva is an all-time great, one of the most accurate strikers to ever fight in the UFC. Fantastic submission skills and an incredibly strong mental game as well.
Oh, he caught him early. Big combination. Big left with a huge left.
Oh, very nice. Oh, solid jab.
Big combination.
Again with a solid kick to the body. Oh!
Trying to stay out of trouble here.
Vicious combinations.
Oh, and another one. That hurt him.
Big shots. Lands a huge kick.
Oh, that's a heavy body kick.
Oh, another body kick. Powerful jab.
He escapes and he gets back up. Strong hook to the body by Weidman. Weidman connects. Joe, he's one of the most powerful punchers in the UFC's middleweight division. He's in a better position here with the tie clinch.
It's a lag fest.
Strong knee to the leg by Weidman.
And he's in the Muay Thai clinch. And he completes a single leg takedown.
Under two. Oh, looking for his back. Oh,
nasty right hand.
Back clinch.
Yeah. Oh, he completes the suplex, man. Seconds on the clock here in round one.
Oh,
wow, the power of the takedown.
Oh, look at this. Traps the arm, throws his leg over the top.
Can he finish the fight here?
It is pretty tight, Mike.
Got it. Put him to sleep. Oh, no, he's dead.
The round was about to end. Sunk in the submission and got the victory.
Let's check out the action on our plate. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Got the submission victory of Anderson Silva. Anderson Silva could not rectify and you know, right the wrong. No, his 2 losses to Chris Weidman. Deuce, can I help you, man? Why you staring at me like that, man? You got a problem? You got a problem, Deuce? You just want to have, you know, give me some, you know, want me to give you some attention. Damn, Trey. I guess you got it because I was giving him attention, huh? You're jealous, right?
The All-American Weidman and the youngest champion in UFC history, Johnny Bones Jones. Our tale of the tape for our main event of the evening. Jones is 28. Weidman is 31. Jones is 2 inches taller. He will have a 6.
It's gonna be my last one, fellas.
And once again,
I'm going to eat my chicken.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
Get out of my face, man. Why are you all in my face? Why are you staring at me? Get out of here. Jeez. Y'all all in my face. Go.
Chris Weidman, John Jones.
Johnny Bones Jones. Oh, Lord Jesus. The lag is real. What in the world is going on here? I don't like this at all. Lag Central. Lag Central. Connection to the opponent has been lost. I guess he quit. Guess he ain't want these problems. You saw that I had the champion trunks on. He's like, oh shit, he must be good. Their fight outcome is being processed. Try, I got it later. Excuse me. Montre Bear. Champion. Wow. That's actually very matching light heavyweight with Chris Weidman. I just want to know, do you get any pleasure of licking his ear, Trey?
Here we go! Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Weidman. Black trunks for Weidman.
Chris Weidman is a multiple-time Division I All-American wrestler with fantastic submission abilities, an iron chin, heart and will, as well as knockout punching power.
All right, looking for the pairs.
A high one.
Weidman with a solid 1-2.
Ah, come on, baby. You got parry, though. You got parry, me, though.
They go to the clinch here early.
Suck each other. Suck each other. Suck it out, man. Suck it out.
Joey's looking for some
control. Suck it out. Suck it out.
And he's going to try to take the back.
Nah. 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 No.
Great position mounted here.
Oops. No. I'm a nose itch.
Weidman with a strong elbow to the head.
No.
There's a nice elbow again.
No.
He's doing a great job of utilizing the ground and pound here, really getting off some excellent shots.
He connects with a big punch from the top.
No.
Here's a little piece of trivia for folks who don't know. The reason why you're not allowed to do a downward elbow 12 to 6
no.
is because when they first brought mixed martial arts to athletic commissions, the people on the commission said, well, you can't let someone do that. I saw people break bricks with that on ESPN. In reality, there's really very little difference.
Between off you up, and he quit. And he quit. Damn, he quit. He quit. Ah, bad. Oops. Middleweight.
It's a middleweight showcase between Chris
about never touching
Weidman and Rory Red King McDonald. Our tale of the tape for this middleweight fight. The Canadian is 26. The American is 31. He is 2 inches taller. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. And with the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 18 wins, 4 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 185 pounds, fighting out of Montreal, Quebec, Canada.
Rory McDonald, the Red King.
Rory McDonald. Here we go. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Okay.
Black trunks for Weidman. Keep an eye out for Chris Weidman's takedowns. He may go to them early.
There's a good jab. Heavy kick to the midsection.
Body kick, look at that.
I know, bro.
Again with a solid kick to the body.
I know,
strong
bro.
Strong jab. Vicious combinations. Hard straight punch.
I know that's what you want, bro.
Another ferocious body kick from Weidman.
Joe, you're absolutely right. Those kicks to the body are doing serious damage. Continuing to land his strikes. Joe, you can hear Firas Sahabi in the corner of McDonald telling him to simply relax.
Why? Just why?
Posture's up here. He's in half guard here. Wow, look at that.
How good is that?
Uh-oh.
McDonald with a nice strike from the bottom. He lands a solid elbow.
There's another elbow.
Man, a ton of damage has been done.
You're fucked up now.
His left eye is really starting to swell up. Joey's scoring with his ground and pound.
Hip escape. Nice hip escape.
Transition.
You don't fluffed up now.
This is where those knees to the body can come and play.
Oh, no. See, this is where he fucked up.
Nice
and Manana ain't like he is in the welterweight division. Can't hang with these dudes.
Nice strike from top position.
Trying to take the back here. This is it. He's going to roll for the knee bar. He's gonna lean back, goes lean under, back, grabs the leg,
grabs the leg,
and he escaped during the roll.
McDonald's trying to isolate that leg.
He rolls out of the knee bar and he escapes.
Is it, I think, is it right? Okay, hold on. Let me see if it's right.
He pulled his leg free.
He pulled his leg free.
Or is it?
McDonald's looking for the leg here.
He rolls and escapes from the knee bar.
I don't know what, how to defend that.
Nice. Pops that leg out of there.
How do I defend that?
Looks like he's got a submission locked up.
It can't be up. Because he's not attacking up. Maybe it is. I don't know. We get into backside again. I'm gonna try to defend that.
And here's another clean shot that lands. Here's a powerful head kick that lands.
Smashed my head on the keyboard.
The battle continues, round two. Comes out swinging.
Great combinations. I like the way he's mixing these up. He's doing a really good job of timing these shots.
Weidman with the jab.
And he's throwing more.
Oh, that's a vicious kick. Wow. Oh, my goodness. Wow.
He's hurt.
Big straight punch.
Oh.
Head kick. Hurt him with that right.
Turning into an all-out slugfest.
Solid jab.
Ah, don't lag. Whoa, look at the... Really? Really?
All right, here we go, round two.
That madness. That madness.
McDonald's body continues to get punished. There is some serious bruising.
That madness, man.
He tags him with the punch. Joey's really starting to connect with that jab here in the second round. Joe, that's another big...
Why is it lagging so...
...needs to start blocking these. Chris Weidman's
continuing... Oh, man.
And he goes down. He's in big trouble here.
All right. Nah, I figured it out. Okay, here we go.
Wow, look at that.
Get out of here. I get... I'm a fucking little knee bar shit.
TKO victory. He was not intelligently defending himself. Too many big shots get through, and that's the end of the...
Sorry, man. I didn't mean to call him a faggot, though, boy. I knew he was going to try it again. So, forget about it here. Let's get one more in. Ugh. I'm going to heat up my food. My boy lost. Y'all always want to play around, man. Get out of my face. Leave me alone, doggies.
Coming up next, it's a
Robert Lawler again.
Between Chris, the All-American Weidman, and knockout artist, Robbie Lawler. Our tale of the tape for this middleweight fight. Weidman is 31. Lawler is 33. Weidman is 3 inches taller. He will have a 4-inch reach advantage. And with the official introductions,
Robert Lawler. Let's get it, Roberts. You're my last victim.
Chris Weidman, Robbie Lawler. Here we go.
Fight's NG Guo. I'm not across that fucking shit.
White trunks for Lawler. Black trunks for Weidman.
One of Robbie's best weapons are his elbow strikes. Robbie is devastating with that technique. Very accurate and very aggressive with it. Keep an eye out for them in this fight. Doing a good job timing his shots here and landing a great series of punches.
Delivered that right to the midsection of his opponent.
Huge kick to the body.
Oh, oh. Combination.
Oh, very nice. Hard straight punch. Oh, he's going for it here.
Oh, okay. Okay. Just let him rip.
Oh, he missed that kick.
I'm missing this kick.
Man came out hard. Heavy kick to the midsection.
Oh, big shots. Oh, head kick.
With the kick. Oh, big right. Solid shot to the body.
Especially with these body kicks.
Just missed with that huge kick.
Good combination.
Big shots.
Strong jab.
You want to do that? I can do that so much.
Big straight punch. He's teeing off with some vicious shots.
I'm gonna do that 1-2 head kick spam shit too, man. Hey, people play like that. You got no other combos in your repertoire.
Robbie Lawler connects. Don't forget, he debuted in the UFC in May of 2002. He was 20 years old, 4-0. Not surprisingly, with 4 knockouts.
Oh, flying knee!
Oh, big elbow. Oh, nice.
Went right to it again.
Oh, that's a heavy body kick. Solid jab.
Look at this. Hard straight punch.
Oh, and another one. That hurt him.
Oh, what an exchange. Big straight punch.
Beautiful nice left hand.
Oh, my God. Oh my lord!
Wow, that's a big left hand. Vicious combination.
Ah, was
Chris
Beautiful
body shot
moved.
There too.
He should have dropped.
Oh, big right hand clipped him. Hard overhand punch.
Big combination.
He's nice catching me, man.
Joey's really setting a frenetic pace. Really striking a lot. Very aggressive attack. Nice leg kick by Lawler.
Kick to the body.
Cutting into an all-out slugfest. There's a nice combination. Oh!
Yo! He is not... Drop it! Catch it!
Excellent strike.
We catching him, Trey. We catching him, bro. Catching him, Trey. He is not dropping.
And we start round two.
Oh, man. We got more salmon in there. You taunting, dog? You taunting? You taunting, dog?
Chris Weidman is the quintessential gritty, tough wrestler. He's got knockout power in his punches. He's got a fantastic submission game and excellent wrestling. Whether he chooses to use it to keep the fight standing or whether he takes opponents down to ground and
clap your
hands. Or submit them.
He was able to block that big punch to the head. Weidman was...
Oh, nice kick to the liver. You can tell he's hurt to the body here, Mike.
Oh, he's in big trouble. Wow!
Nice jab. Big punches here. Hard straight punch.
Boom to the body.
Oh,
got clipped. Uh-oh, these are big strikes.
Vicious shot to the body.
Oh, he's landing at will. Oh, big body kick.
Hit him with the right hand.
Oh, right into the midsection.
Nice body kick.
Oh, that's a big left. Chris Weidman displaying that.
I'm trying to parry.
He is going after it here.
Why are you dropping it? Ah!
He just missed with the right.
Ah, this dude is
good
running.
Oh, he's tagging him.
What? Oh, man.
Vicious attack by Lawler.
Big combination.
You funny.
Oh, he's landing.
Oh, my God.
Big straight punch. Oh, that one hurt him. Big shots. I like that, Mike. I like how he's mixing
it up. Come on. Come on.
Big power jab.
Hard straight punch.
Come on.
Vicious combination.
Wow. Come on.
This could be it right here.
Oh, that big right hand.
Oh, he's landed some good shots here.
He scores with a huge left.
Hard jab.
Big punch is landing.
What a body.
Get out of here.
Oh,
come on. Goodbye.
Like
we ended on that note.
It was a shot.
We ended on. Nah, you know what? Let's get another one in, man. I'm in a good mood, even though I'm tired as fuck. Tired as all fluff. Let's end it on a good note. On a better note. I ain't like how I got rocked right there. What, man? What you want, man? Get out of my face. What do you want his attention? Go lay down with Deuce. Deuce chilling, man. Why you gotta be all in my face and crying and stuff? What you want, man? You ate, you went outside, you peed, you pooped, you did all that. What you wanna? I'm not playing with you, man. I'm done. Yeah, I hear my dog whining. No, Trey, get out of here. Please stop. Yeah, Henderson?
Between Chris, the All-American Weidman, and the Olympian, Dan Henderson. Our tale of the tape for this middleweight championship fight. Weidman is 31. Henderson is 45. Weidman is 3 inches taller. He will have a 4-inch reach advantage. Bruce Buffer.
4-inch reach advantage.
Chris Weidman, Dan Henderson. Title fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. White trunks.
Yep, you looking for that H bomb? Parry H bomb.
Chris Weidman throws everything with vicious intentions, particularly his kicks.
He misses with the straight right. He was able to block that big kick. Weidman with a good straight to the body.
Can't keep him at bay.
Straight punch gets through.
That punch was blocked.
People like this get on my nerves.
Into the fight, and both men are still trying to find their range.
This is still a feeling out process. Both guys are trying to find their timing, and you're right, neither guy has really stepped out ahead.
Very nice counter right there. Good block by Henderson.
Both men landing in that exchange.
What?
Joe, we can see the game plan here. Punish his opponent's leg with some vicious kicks.
Yep. Hard body kick from Weidman. Nice shot.
And again he connects. Weidman with the right hook to the body.
Another to the body.
Combination by the champion.
Knee to the body here.
Henderson counters with the right. Nice.
Nice 1-2. He's moving to the right, trying to avoid that big right hand. Doing an excellent job of mixing up his strikes here. He's got the clinch.
And he connects here.
Nice punch in the clinch.
Henderson with a strong elbow to the head.
90 seconds now on the clock.
Strong hook to the body by Henderson.
They're both staying in tight, close, right in the fire.
Good uppercut.
That's a big elbow, Joe.
Huge elbow.
Oh, he's landing at will. Big connection with the elbow.
Vicious shot to the body.
Huge elbow.
Oh, man, that is rough. Oh, nice uppercut. He hurt him with that hook.
30 seconds. Oh,
the knee.
Weidman with a good uppercut in the clinch.
His left eye is really starting to swell here. Good job landing the series of strikes here. And here's a nice
good first round for us.
Round two. Joe, just like the last round.
Dude, look at that. See, that's what pissed me off. Come on. I'm not going to deal with that.
And once again, he looks sensational. Solid elbow from the clinch.
Trying to grab the leg, and he does.
Wow, yeah, that's a block that.
Ever battle in the octagon. Hendo with another takedown.
Nice left hand. He's doing a great job of ground and pound here. Ripping to the body and to the head. Staying busy.
Nice punch by Weidman.
He's stuck in half guard here, but he's landing some nasty combinations.
Great punch by Henderson. Nice work from the bottom.
Excellent ground and pound here, not giving his opponent any breaks.
Joe, not much going on here.
They both seem to be either taking a bit of a breather or they're canceling each other out with their moves and counters.
Some ground and pound.
Joe, you can see the effects of those body shots. There's a ton of bruising on his right side.
Chris Weidman with some vicious body shots.
Oh, for sure.
Just looking for the parry.
Under three.
They are exchanging here, Mike.
Henderson with the combination.
Oh,
right into the midsection.
Nice body kick. Big straight punch.
Oh, he's landing. Caught him with a big right hand. That punch had knockout written all over it.
Oh, nice.
Huge block. That was a big kick to the body.
Oh, my God. I hate that, yo.
That connected. And another strike lands. Joey did a nice job blocking that punch.
Good straight right.
Solid punch by Henderson.
Why do I keep falling for that?
Good defense with the parry. Nice work with the straight right.
Yo, this dude is just really a parry master.
Right behind it.
Chris Weidman's continuing to target that cut.
He certainly is. He's absolutely targeting that cut, and that is going to open up even wider now. Excellent job of landing punches here.
Man, Joe, it's going according to game plan here. Defend and counter.
Nicely done.
Yo, man, really, dude?
Joe, once again, looking for those
that's
counters.
All you got is your parry.
Another shot to that cut that occurred earlier in the fight, and now it's really wide open.
Yeah, he keeps tagging him right on that same spot.
Yeah, this dude.
Again, there's that counter.
I can't.
Henderson with a solid jab. And that's the end of round number two. Dan Henderson's cheek is a mess. I think the doctor's gonna have to take.
What a great round. This fight is really shaping up.
It's all you're doing, walk forward and parry. I never saw like nah. I this is just one of these matches where you gotta deal with a parry.
Joe, that was a good round we just saw. It'll be very interesting to see if the fighters can keep this pace. Though
I think they will keep this pace.
Ah, come on, don't lag on me now.
As we head down the home stretch. Oh, head kick.
Come on, don't lag on me now, dude.
He's circling to his right.
This fucking shit. Fucking shit lagging. Oh man, come on. What he did to
Michael Bisping. Good 1-2.
We take a look at the striking accuracy for Chris Weidman.
Oh my god, dude. 68%
of his total strikes.
Oh, now I feel major lag, man.
Got hit with a left. Looking to soften up his opponent.
This fight very well may be stopped in between rounds just because of the blood loss, Mike, because that is extraordinary.
Perfect timing with his strikes. Nice straight right by Henderson. Henderson's got a good Greco background as well, so he doesn't mind the clinch here. Henderson gets him in the plum.
Oh, he takes him down.
Under 3 minutes. Half guard.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Weidman goes into side control.
Locked it.
Oh, good punches from the top here.
He might get it, Joe.
This is very tight. He's in big trouble.
Looking for the finish.
That shit did not pop up at that.
Half guard.
He lands a big shot from the bottom. Nice sweep.
Good defense against the hammer fist.
In the full guard.
Weidman going to work from guard.
Caught him with a punch.
Pulling right back down the guard.
And he's got some good effectiveness going with the ground and pound. Man, those body shots have been lethal. Look at the bruising on his right side. Weidman gets it to half guard.
Back to full guard.
Oh, he's punishing the body from the top. He got his hips well enough to get back to half guard. Full guard. 20 seconds.
Excellent movement here on the ground.
Good connection with the elbow. Able to posture up and deliver some ground and pound.
That was our round. Pretty good with Pando, I'm not going to lie. Ooh, we got 6 viewers in here. Holla. Let's go. I love y'all.
And here's a nice shot, lands perfectly.
The beautiful
area. That's the most views I ever had on this end. On the Xbox side, because I really rarely view on the Xbox side. Or, you know what I mean, broadcast, whatever. I'm tired. I'm ready to go to sleep. Got a long day, long night ahead of me tonight. Last day of work, then I'm out the next 2 nights. Holla.
Round 4. This fight scheduled for 5 minute rounds. Joe, they battled for 3 rounds. And now we move to the championship rounds. What should we look for?
The championship rounds is what separates the good fighters from the great fighters. The fighters who work hard, to the fighters who literally dedicate every blood, sweat, and tear drop that they have inside of their body. This is where you get to see what a fighter's really made of. That bruise on his torso is getting really nasty.
Check it out. Body strikes land.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange. Oh, nice body shot.
Man, Joe, this is counter-striking 101. What a clinic. And again, he lands the body shot. Timing his strikes nicely. Missed with that one.
That's the only thing I don't respect about his game. It's just fishing for parries.
Continuing to punish that wounded eye. And you can
can see that the swelling continues to get worse and worse.
He's absolutely targeting that eye. You can clearly see, and he's landing combinations on it repeatedly. Hit him with the jab.
Good job blocking the shot to the body. And he counters with the straight right. Dan Henderson looking for another highlight reel knockout. The one against Bisping Joe, one of the greatest in MMA history. Henderson with a good punch. Continuing to strike well. Weidman gets hit with that inside leg.
Yeah, come on, man.
Joey defends the head strike with the parry. Weidman with the solid straight. 2 minutes remain in the round. Good 1-2 combo by Weidman.
Nice right hand.
Parry master to his head.
Nasty combinations here.
Oh, big right.
Oh.
Man, throw, man.
He's able to block the punch. Oh, big right hand. Oh, Joe, another strong jab.
Hard straight punch.
Good combinations.
Hurt him with that right.
Punches and bunches. He wants the finish.
This dude has no skill, dude. That's all. You know what? I'm not dealing with it. I'll fucking grapple you, man.
30 seconds.
Trying to get a single.
That's a big takedown late in the round.
He got tagged there.
I saw the cut when it was first open, Joe, but it's really swelling up quickly. Into the round, and that was a huge takedown that will score points. Dan Henderson.
Dude, it's really just fish. Fish. I gotta end it. Cause I know I'm not gonna win this fight. For some reason, I feel I'm not gonna win this fight if I don't end the fight. As he's fishing for parries, and then Joe 1-2 late kick, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Like, come on, man.
Joe, I think we can describe this in 4 words: fight of the night.
Look, see.
This is an all-out war. These guys are leaving it all in the cage.
And then 1-2, man, this fucking dude, yo.
He connects with the straight. Nice combination.
He's sucking fucking mean cock
and
right now.
He continues to mix up his strikes. Nice shot.
Great exchanges.
He avoided damage blocking the big kick. We go inside the numbers and we see the total strikes land. Doing a good job with his strike.
The kick lands to the liver. He's hurt bad.
Faggot.
He's trying to stay up. He is in big, big trouble.
Strong jab.
Oh, he's landing some good shots here. Big straight punch.
Oh, and another jab. Big power jab.
Vicious.
Oh, he's clean.
Wow.
Pussy.
Oh, he's out cold. Just like
that. I get out of here. I'm gonna end it like that. Spectacular fashion. Get him out of here, yo. That just pissed me off. Fucking fishing for parries. Stepping straight to Andy. Stepping straight to end this fag bag.
As it lands, immediately his opponent goes left. Here we see it again. And he's out. Bruce Buffer.
Thank you for the viewers that came in and supported. I'm out.